Hello everyone. In this video session, I am going to explain part 89 of Java for Tester series, that is arrays and data types. So far, in the previous videos, I have created the arrays using the int data type. Okay, whether it may be a single dimensional array or two dimensional array or three dimensional array, I declared so far in all the previous examples or previous topics of arrays I explained, I use the int data type. But arrays are not restricted to int data type, guys. You can create different data types of arrays. Okay. So in this current video session, I am going to explain arrays and different data types. So let me practically show you how you can create different arrays using the different data types. Okay. Arrays are not restricted to only int data type, guys. You can use different data types for creating these arrays. Okay. So in this video, I am going to explain that. So let's go here and let me create let's start with the integer array itself, guys. I'll create a single dimensional integer array. I'll create a variable a, and I will write something like this. Okay. This is a single dimensional integer array, guys. This is an integer array, guys. As you can see, since this variable is declared with this integer array data type, we can store multiple integer literals into this variable like this. This works, right? This is how it works. Now what if I create something like this? Okay, instead of int, I will use long array. Okay, this is a long array, guys. Long array, I'll create a variable b is equal to I'll create some single dimensional array here. And here I will give the letters as 9L. Okay. So some 1, 2, 3L, 56L, and so on. You can give any kind of thing. You see, here the literals are long literals, guys. They are ending with L. So these are long literals. These are integer literals, whereas these are long literals. Since you have declared this variable B with long array data type, you can store multiple long literals. Similar way, I can create a array having the char data type. This is a char array. Okay, I'm declaring a variable c with char array data type. So into the single dimensional array, I can store literals like s, a, p, t, and so on. Okay, these are the character literals, guys. Multiple character literals I am assigning to the variable c because it is declared with which data type? Character array data type. Then what if I do something like this? String d is equal to, okay, string array d is equal to. In this case, guys, I can store multiple string literals. Okay, I can store string literals like this. Here, fox.com. okay, testing, tutorials, and so on. These are all the different string literals, guys, I am storing into this variable d, which is declared with string array data type. What if I give something like this? Boolean. Okay, boolean array e is equal to. Here, guys, I can store boolean values like this: true, false. Multiple boolean values I can store into this variable because this variable is declared with boolean array data type. So anything left? Floating point. Okay, float array data type. So I can store floating point values like 1.23f, comma 3.69f, okay, 4.52f, and so on. So if you declare a variable with floating point array data type, then you can store multiple floating point literals into this variable. Now one more thing that is left is double array g is equal to. I can store all the decimal values, double literals, 3.456 comma 2.123 comma 1.23 comma 34.56, and so on, all the decimal values. By default, all the decimal values will be double literals and they can be assigned to the variable g, which is declared with double array data type. Like this, guys, you can store, okay, We can even create byte short and all those stuff also. Okay, byte g is equal to 1, 5, 9, okay, 3, like this. This is a byte short. Also, I can do that. Short array I is equal to, okay, 6, 3, 2, 8. Byte short, int long, float double, char, boolean, and string. Okay, so like this guys, arrays can be used with different data types. Arrays can be used with different data types like this. Okay, you see, if you declare a particular array with int data type, you can store integer literals into that variable of int data type declared variable. Okay, and if you declare some variable as a string array, you can store all the string literals like this based on the multiple values. Based on the type of the values that you want to store into this variable, you can declare the variable of that kind of data type. It's not only limited to single arrays, guys. If you have multiple multi-dimensional arrays, that's fine. Like you can, okay, it's also applicable to the two-dimensional and three-dimensional arrays also. Okay, in this example, I only provided all the single-dimensional arrays with different data types. But the same thing can be applied for the two-dimensional and three-dimensional arrays that you can experiment and see on your own, guys. Okay, like this, guys. In Java, we can use arrays with different data types. Okay, integer arrays, character arrays, string arrays, double arrays, floating point arrays, boolean arrays, short arrays, byte arrays, okay, long arrays, and so on. All the different data types can be used with arrays for storing that kind of literals into the variables of that array type. So that's it, guys. This is all about the arrays and data types. In the next video session, I'll explain about object class arrays. Okay, the next type of arrays, that is object class arrays, I will explain in the next video session. So that's it, guys. See you in the next video session. Thank you. Bye.